Determine whether each sequence is arithmetic. If it is, then determine D, the common difference. There's a couple of ways we can do this. Informally, a sequence is arithmetic if we add the same constant to the previous term to get the next term, then the sequence is arithmetic. Or more formally, if the sequence is arithmetic, then a sub n minus a sub n minus 1 always equals d, the common difference. Notice a sub n minus 1 is the term right before the term a sub n. Let's analyze the sequences using both approaches. For the first sequence, if we're looking for a pattern of addition, notice that 2 plus 5 equals 7. 7 plus 5 is equal to 12. 12 plus 5 is equal to 17. 17 plus 5 is equal to 22. Because we're adding the same constant to the previous term to get the next term, we know we have an arithmetic sequence, and because we're adding 5 each time, the common difference D is 5. So we'll answer yes, it is arithmetic, and the common difference D equals 5. But let's also show how to calculate the common difference D using pairs of terms in the sequence. The common difference D using the formula and the first two terms must be equal to a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which is 7 minus 2, which equals 5. Using the second and third terms, we'd have the common difference D equals a sub 3 minus a sub 2, which is 12 minus 7, which equals 5. Let's just show one more. Using the third and fourth terms, the common difference D equals a sub 4 minus a sub 3, which equals 17 minus 12, which is 5. So whichever approach we take, the sequence is arithmetic and the common difference D is 5. Notice the three formulas here we use to determine D do fit the form of D equals a sub n minus a sub n minus 1. Let's take a look at the next sequence. Looking for a pattern of addition, we might be thinking negative 1 minus 4 equals negative 5, which is true, but we can also write minus 4 as plus negative 4. So informally, we can also look for a pattern of subtraction, again, because every subtraction problem can be written as an addition problem. But I'm going to go ahead and write plus negative 4. But notice now the pattern breaks down immediately, because negative 5 plus negative 4 is negative 9, not negative 10. So because we're not adding the same constant to the previous term to get the next term, we know that the sequence is not arithmetic. So we can go ahead and say no. But let's also try to determine a couple of values for the common difference D using the formula. The common difference D, if we use, let's say, a sub 4 and a sub 3, we'd have a sub 4 minus a sub 3, which is negative 16 minus negative 10, which simplifies to negative 16 plus 10, which is negative 6. And now let's determine a second common difference D. Let's use a sub 2 and a sub 1. The common difference D must equal a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which would be negative 5 minus negative 1, which is negative 5 plus 1, which is negative 4. We obtained a different value for D, and as soon as we do, we know the sequence is not arithmetic. Moving along to the next sequence, looking for a pattern of addition. Notice 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. 10 plus 4 is 14, not 16. So here we have to add 6 to get 16, the next term of the sequence. We're not adding the same constant, which indicates the answer is no, the sequence is not arithmetic. But again, let's go ahead and determine a couple of values for D to show we get different values. Using a sub 2 and a sub 1, the common difference D must equal a sub 2 minus a sub 1 if it's arithmetic, which gives us 10 minus 6, which is 4. Let's jump out to a sub 5 and a sub 4. If we did have an arithmetic sequence, the common difference D would also have to be equal to a sub 5 minus a sub 4, which in our case is 34 minus 24, which is 10. And as soon as we get two different values for D, we know the sequence is not arithmetic. And for the last example, analyzing the sequence and looking for a pattern of addition, negative 4 plus 3 is equal to negative 1. Negative 1 plus 3 is positive 2. 2 plus 3 is positive 5. And 5 plus 3 is positive 8. Notice we're adding the same constant to the previous term to get the next term in the sequence, which means the sequence is arithmetic. We answer yes. And the common difference d equals 3. And one more time, let's use the formula for d. The common difference d equals, let's use a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which is negative 1 minus negative 4, which is negative 1 plus 4, which is 3, which is what we expect. And let's jump out to, let's say, a sub 4 and a sub 3. The common difference d, it must also equal a sub 4 minus a sub 3, which is 5 minus 2, which does equal 3. This would be true for any a sub n minus a sub n minus 1 for the sequence, which is why it is arithmetic. I hope you found this helpful.